Hey guys, Liz here from Hustle and Groove, and in this tutorial video, I'm going to walk you through how to set up your nonfiction formatting. So, how to format a book inside Scrivener. Now, the reason that I use Scrivener is because one, it's my go-to writing tool. I write everything inside here. But secondly, it's because it exports to pretty much every single format that you could possibly need in terms of getting your book out there. So, in terms of distribution. So, if you need an EPUB file, if you need a MOBI file, if you need a doc file, if you need a PDF, it does all of that and so much more. So, slight caveat, when it comes to Scrivener and the formatting side of things, this is all about simplicity. So, if you're looking for some amazing graphics coming off the page, or if you need some formatting like that, then you'll definitely need to go to something like InDesign or pay for a designer to do that for you. But if you want to keep your nonfiction book simple and easy for people to consume, then Scrivener is definitely what I would recommend. So, first things first, let's talk about some best practices. You want to only choose one or two fonts, and you can change the way a book looks and the way that it feels with fonts. So, that's one of the really great things about this, is that you can choose different fonts to make things stand out. Now, I am talking about the print version when I'm talking about this, because when it comes to your Kindle version and your EPUB version, so the ebook versions, those are only your fonts are only chosen based on whatever device the user has access to, and there's only about three or four fonts, so those will always be converted. So just bear that in mind, that you don't have a lot of control over the font when it comes to the ebook side. But when it comes to the print version, you can literally choose whatever you like. So I'm going to walk you through from a print perspective, because I feel like lots and lots more people are doing print books now. I personally love print books, and whenever I publish a book, I do both a print and a Kindle book, just because I always like to have my own books in my hands. So I always switch between Helvetica and Cambria in terms of the fonts. Those are basically my two go-to fonts. So you'll see that I've actually chosen normal Helvetica here for the title, sorry, Helvetica Neue for these two. And then in terms of my actual content, like the actual bones of the book, I've switched to Cambria, and I generally go with a font size of 11 for my print books. So the thing that you can do with your print books to make things stand out is to use things like I've done with this quote, is I've put a table around it, and I've used caps to make things stand out. You could use italics as well. So really, it's just getting familiar with how you can use different fonts and different size fonts to make things work for you. So the really cool thing about Scrivener is that there are two ways that you can export your book in terms of how it's going to look. So you can come in here and you can do all this amazing formatting, or you can do that from within your actual compile settings. So this is what makes Scrivener so amazing. So this particular book I have set up for formatting to be overwritten by what I've done in compile. And I'm going to show you how that looks different in the next video if you want to override that and do it from within your document, and why you might do that. So I have chosen to do a couple of different levels. So I have chosen to format, and you'll see on the left-hand side as I go through, things will be highlighted. So that very first one was highlighting those folders, but they are not in the compile, so I haven't touched them. The only thing that I've done is said that they are going to be chapter one. So that is the title that is going to be included. And all that you need to do is come in here and click on it. And if you need to format, you would just click on the font and that would pop open, and you can just move that around. So totally up to you. So I've stuck with Cambria in this instance for that. So that's just for those. And then as you click through all the different levels, you'll see where I might have actually done something. So if I come back to here, so these are all my subheadings and my chapter title. So I should say that chapter title before wasn't included because I've chosen to set mine up slightly differently. So this is where you can come in and you choose all of this, and you'll make sure that you are including the title and the text of what's ever in this document. So those two things are super important to make sure that those have been included. And then whatever is here is overwritten in whatever you've got set inside the actual document. So that means if this is ticked here, it overrides what you do inside the document. So this is how compile formats everything for you. So just in case you've done something, you've imported text from somewhere, maybe you're using your blog to create your book, that way you don't have to worry about going through and formatting it all as you go. You can just come in here into compile and just go override, and it's going to do that for you. So you have a few more options in terms of doing that. If you want to preserve the line spacing, if you want to preserve center text, then you would go ahead and choose that. And this is by default, it always does that. If you want to only, if you want to have a bit more control, then you can choose to only preserve formatting, and then it only preserves the font size. Maybe that's all that you're worried about. But otherwise, you can just leave that as is. And then I'm just going to come back through and see if there are lots of different options. So then this is the bulk of the actual book. So you'll see that back up here at level, let me see if I can find it, level two. That is like a chapter section. And then level three is the actual bones of the book. So this is again the same thing. You come in here and you choose all the different things that you can do to format your font. So as long as you're making sure that the title and the text is included and that this is ticked, this is going to override whatever you've got hanging out in your actual document. So there are a couple of other things that you can do too, to make sure that this all looks the same. You can choose different layout options. I definitely don't do that. Transformations, I come in here and I straighten smart quotes so that they're not curly. I convert ellipses to triple periods because that's how I roll. And I also make sure to tick this one here called convert multiple spaces to single spaces. So this is super handy if for whatever reason you have done two spaces after a full stop, which is how we used to format, but now there's only one space after a full stop. So super easy. If you forget and you've done the double spacing, which sometimes I do, it's super simple to come in and catch that here. And there's a whole bunch of other things as well, like you can choose to remove trailing white space from documents. So that's if you've hit return a couple of times at the end of your actual document and you've forgotten you've missed it, you can come in and tick that. So just a couple of areas that you can do to help format that. So that is how you would go about setting up your formatting. You would do that all from within compile, and you do that under formatting. And it will highlight the different areas as you go through so that you know what you're actually formatting. So there are also a couple of other options. If you click into section layout, if you wanted to force uppercase, if you want small caps, if you want the titles to run in the head, you can do that. If you want your first few letters of your paragraph to be in caps, you can totally do that as well. So there's lots of different things that you can do. I tend not to do that because I'm all about simplicity. I want to keep things as simple as possible. So that's how you can go about compiling and formatting your book inside Scrivener. In the next video, I am going to show you how to do it from within your actual document so you can see the difference, and maybe it will work for you, maybe it won't. So the one really cool thing about this is that if you do it from within compile, you do not have to do anything else. Like you don't have to come in and fiddle with pages, you don't have to come in and put a blank page somewhere. You can do it all from within compile. You can choose to force a new chapter to start on a right side or a left side. So the compile functionality gives you so much more control, but you might like to do things slightly differently. So come join me in the next video.